Match the graph with the correct equation. A, y equals x, b, y equals 2x, c, y equals x over 2, and d, y is equal to 4x. Notice that all the graphs are graphs of lines, and that all the equations are linear equations. So what we'll need to recall for this particular exercise is that a linear equation has the form y is equal to mx plus b, the coefficient of x, the m, is the slope, and the constant term is the y-intercept, or b is the y-intercept. So the first step that I would recommend would be to rewrite each of the equations in that form. For a, we have y equals x. Well, we need to think of y is equal to some number times x plus some number. Well, we could rewrite that as y is equal to 1x plus 0. Y equals 1x plus 0. So now we can see that the slope is equal to 1 and that the y-intercept is 0. For b, we have y is equal to 2x, and then we need to think of adding some number. Well, we could add 0. So the slope is 2 and the y-intercept is 0. For c, we have y is equal to x over 2, but dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by a half, so we can rewrite this as y equals 1 half x plus 0. And then d, y equals 4x, can be written as y is equal to 4x plus 0. So what we notice right away is that each of them is adding 0, so each graph will have to have a y-intercept of 0. Graph A has a y-intercept of 0. Graph B has a y-intercept of 0. Graph C and also graph D, they all have a y-intercept of 0. So the thing that's going to distinguish all the graphs is their slope. Now at first glance, it would appear that all the graphs have the same steepness and therefore maybe the same slope. But upon closer inspection, we see that the graphs have different scales. Here, the y-axis is scaled by 5, whereas here the y-axis is scaled by 1. And here the y-axis is scaled by 2, and the x-axis is scaled by 5. So in order to find the slopes of the different graphs, we'll want to recall that slope is equal to rise over run. So for graph A, we'll pick two points. We've already picked the origin. Perhaps we could pick this point up here. And we need to ask ourselves, how much do we have to rise and then run in order to go from one point to the next? Well, it appears we need to rise a little bit more than 10, maybe 12. And then we need to go over 3. And 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. So we want a line with a slope of 4, and we see that that matches D. Y is equal to 4x plus 0. So graph A matches D. And let's go on to graph B. We could pick another point. Actually, this one will work. And we see that as we go from this point to this point, that we're rising 1 and running 1. 1 over 1 is equal to 1. The slope of this line is 1, and therefore we need to pick an equation that has a m value of 1, and that is A. So A corresponds with graph B. If we look at C, we want to pick two points on the line. And we see that going from the first point to the second point, we need to rise about halfway between 4 and 6 is 5. So we need to go up 5 and then over 10. 5 over 10, that reduces to 1 half. So we want a line with a slope of 1 half, and that matches C. So C corresponds with graph C. And then finally, graph D. We pick two points on the line. In order to go from the first point to the second point, we need to rise a little bit more than 10, about 12 units. And then we need to go over 6. 12 over 6 is equal to 2. We want a line with a slope of 2, and that matches the equation given in B. Y is equal to 2x plus 0 corresponds with graph D.